हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस न्यू चैप्टर, दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 4, चेंज इन प्रॉफिट शेयरिंग रेशियो अमंग द एग्जिस्टिंग पार्टनर्स। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वांट टू टेल यू दैट इन पार्टनरशिप देयर इज एन एग्रीमेंट बिटवीन द पार्टनर्स। So according to that agreement, they can change the terms of their agreement whenever they want or when there is the reconstitution of partnership firm. So there are the different cases we can say when the partnership firm can be reconstituted. So what are the events? First one is change in the profit sharing ratio among the existing partners. When there is change in the profit sharing ratio among the existing partners, the partners when they are continue their business and want to change their profit sharing ratio, that is called the change in profit sharing ratio among the existing partners. Second case is admission of a partner. Sometimes a partner or partners may be admitted in the partnership firm. So at that time also, there will be some changes in the partnership firm. At the time of retirement also, when one partner retires or leaves the firms, so at that time also there are many changes considered in the firm. Death of partner, when there is a death of partner, then also there are so many changes in the firm. Amalgamation of two or more partnership. Amalgamation means when two or more partnership firms join together. That is called the amalgamation. So at that time also there are changes. Now what type of changes are there at that time when there is the reconstitution of partnership firm? First of all, we will discuss that change in the profit sharing ratio among the existing partners. So when there is reconstitution of firm, or we can say on different occasions, then there is the change in the profit sharing ratio. Goodwill is also affected, some adjustment of goodwill is also done, reserves are affected, in the reserves adjustment of reserves are also done. So there are the different events, or we can say different cases, or we can say the different changes took place in the firm at the time of different events, that is admission, retirement, change in profit share. So in this chapter, what we will discuss, if there is the change in profit sharing ratio among the existing partners. First of all, change in the profit sharing ratio among the existing partners. How do we calculate all these, or how we consider this? When the profit sharing ratio is changed, suppose earlier the partners are distributing their profits equally, but now they want some different ratio, suppose 2:3, 3:4, whatever is there. So at that time, some partner will gain and some partner will lose, or we can say some partner have to sacrifice. So in this case, we have to calculate the sacrifice and gain of partners. First of all, sacrifice. Sacrifice means when the old share, okay, when there is old share minus new, that is called the sacrifice. Means when your old share is larger than new share, then it means you are sacrificing, because your older share is more and newer share is less. But gain means, or we can say it is opposite of sacrifice, new minus old, means when the new share of a partner is more than the old ones. So when there is change in the profit sharing ratio, one partner or some partners may sacrifice or gain. So today I will give you an example also, that how we have to calculate this sacrifice or gain. See question number 2. X, Y and Z are sharing profit and losses in the ratio 5:3:2 with effect from 1st April 2019. They decide to share profits and losses in the ratio of 5:2:3. Calculate each partner's gain or sacrifice due to the change in the ratio. Now, earlier partners are getting or sharing profit and losses in the ratio of 5:3:2. But now they want to change their profit sharing ratio. So what is it now? It is 5:2:3. So in this case, how we what we have to do? We have to calculate the gain or sacrifice due to change in the ratio. So how we calculate this? See, X, Y, Z. They are the three partners. Firstly, their profit sharing ratio is 5:3:2. But according to their new agreement or new ratio, they are sharing profit and losses in the ratio of 5:2:3. So you see here, first of all, we will calculate the gain or sacrifice of X. How it will be calculated? X old share is 5/10 minus new share is 5/10. So it becomes 0. X is the partner who didn't gain anything or he did not have to sacrifice anything. Okay. There is no gain and no sacrifice made by the X. Now we come to the Y. In the case of Y, we see the old ratio of or old share of Y is 3/10. Now, 3/10 means 5+3, 8, 8+2, 10. This is the total share. That out of 10, he got the 3 parts of share, 3/10. So, according to the new share, Y got 2/10. Now, if we calculate, if we find out this difference, what we get? Or we come to know about that Y made sacrifice of 1/10. Okay. And Z. What Z has got? Old share is 2/10. New share is 3/10. So if we deduct old from new, it becomes -1/10. It means Z has gained because his new share is more than old share. So, X has sacrificed and Y has gained when there is change in the profit sharing ratio. So, in this way, we calculate the gain or sacrifice made by the partners while change in the profit sharing ratio among the existing partners. No new partner is added, no partner is retiring. Okay, now. Next concept here is the accounting treatment of goodwill. You all know about the goodwill, that how goodwill is calculated, or we have done whole chapter on the basis of goodwill. In that chapter, we have understood the meaning of goodwill, nature of goodwill, what type of asset is this, how it's how it is to be calculated. Okay, now here we will do accounting treatment of goodwill at the time of change in profit sharing ratio. Because when there is change in profit sharing ratio, some partner has to sacrifice and some has gained. Okay. So, the partner which is sacrificing, he has to give his goodwill shares to the gaining partner. So, how we calculate all this? Basically, there are the two treatment of goodwill. In first case, we will raise and write off goodwill. And in second case, what we will do? We just passed an adjustment entry. So we will take a simple example. Firstly, see question number 5 carefully. A, B and C share profit and losses in the ratio of 3:2:1 respectively. With effect from 1st April 2019, they agreed to share profits equally. Earlier their ratio is 3:2:1, now they wants to share equally. The goodwill of the firm was valued at 18,000. Past necessary journal entries, when goodwill is adjusted through a partner's capital account and goodwill is raised or written off. Now both the cases are here. First of all, what we have to do? A, B, C. Three partners are there. Earlier their profit sharing ratio is 3:2:1. But now their profit sharing ratio has been changed. So what is their profit sharing ratio now? Their profit sharing ratio is equal. Okay. And first of all, we have to calculate the gain or sacrifice made by the partners. So firstly, we will take A. It's 3/6 minus 1/3. So we have to calculate the gain or sacrifice made by him. So A has sacrificed 1/6 of his share. Now come to B. It's 2/6 minus 1/3. It becomes 0. No gain or sacrifice made by the B. Now C, 1/6 minus 1/3. So C has gained. Okay, now you all know then when any partner gained something, then it's his capital account is credited. Okay, his capital is increased because he is getting the profit. You all know that when there is the profit in the sole trade business firms, which you have done in class 11, what you will do, you will add the profit in the capital and deduct the loss. If there is profit, then you add the profit in the capital, in the balance sheet. But if there is loss, then you, what you will do, you deduct that loss. So same here, that when any partner gains, his capital increases. So it will be credited to his capital account. Okay. You have done in fundamentals, partnership fundamentals also, that how capital account is prepared. So see here, if a single adjustment entry is made, first of all, the value of goodwill is here 18,000. So what is the share which is sacrificed or gained by the single partner? See here, 1/6 partner is sacrificed by A and 1/6 partner is gained by the C. So 1/6 of 18,000 is 3,000. It means A has sacrificed and C has gained. Okay. So what we will do? In this case, we will, if first case is that goodwill is adjusted through the partner's capital account. So when goodwill is adjusted according to the partner capital account, then what we have to do? It has to make the A has sacrificed. So what we do? And C has gained. C's capital account debit to A's capital account. So in this way, what we will do? We just passed a single entry to adjust that 3000. Okay. Now I think it should be clear to you. First of all, what we have done, we have to do the single adjustment entry. So in this case, what we have seen, that A, B, C are partner, they are sharing profit in this ratio. Now they want to change their profit sharing ratio. Their new profit sharing ratio is equally. Okay. The goodwill of the firm is 18,000. First of all, we will calculate the sacrifice or gain made by the partners. So in this way, we calculate the old share 3/6 minus new share 1/6. So we see that A has, old share is larger than new share, so it has to make sacrifice, and C has gained. Okay. Now the partner who is gaining, try to understand, the partner who is gaining ही विल गिव दिस शेयर टू द पार्टनर हु इज सैक्रिफाइसिंग. दैट्स वाई सीज कैपिटल अकाउंट इज डेबिटेड हेयर बिकॉज फ्रॉम हिज कैपिटल 3,000 इज विड्रॉन एंड गिवन टू द और क्रेडिटेड टू द ए कैपिटल बिकॉज ए इज सैक्रिफाइसिंग. नाउ दिस इज योर फर्स्ट मेथड इन विच सिंगल एंट्री वी कैन पास. सपोज हेयर इज द केस दैट सी इज गेनिंग अलॉन्ग विद द बी इन इक्वल वे. सो एंड ए इज ओनली द सैक्रिफाइसिंग. ओके नाउ वट वी विल डू इन दैट केस. वी विल डेबिट बोथ द बी एंड सी अकाउंट. बी एंड सी अकाउंट विल बी डेबिटेड विद 1500 and A account will be credited because A is sacrificing. Okay, that why his account is credited because he got the share of goodwill due to his sacrifice. Now, what is the raising and return of goodwill? Raised. First, second method is here you have to, what you have to do? Goodwill is raised and written off. Pass necessary journal entries when goodwill is raised. Firstly, when goodwill is raised, what is the meaning of goodwill is raised? First of all, the goodwill is, that is 18,000. So what we will do in that case, first of all, we will distribute that 18,000 to the old partners. Okay, that is A in old ratio to B's capital to C's capital. Old ratio is 9,000, according to old ratio 3:1, 9,000, then after that 6,000 and then 3,000. This is called the raising of goodwill. That the goodwill which is already in the books of accounts, first of all we distribute that goodwill in the old ratio. After calculating the new or after considering the new ratio, when there is the introduction of new ratio, then what we will do? We will charge this goodwill from all the partners in that new ratio. Now new ratio between A, B and C is equal. That is 1:1:1. Okay. Now if we distribute 18,000 in that equal ratio, what we got? 6,000, 6,000, 6,000. Now 6,000, 6,000, 6,000. That is 6,000 from each partner. ABC is collected. A's capital account debit, B's capital account debit, C's capital account debit to goodwill. Try to understand carefully. I am repeating once again. Bachche, if you have to raise, you have to follow the raised and written off. This is called now written off goodwill. इस केस में आपको क्या करना है? अगर आपको बोला गया है कि आपकी जो एग्जिस्टिंग पार्टनर की रेशो जो है वो चेंज हो रही है, तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल हम क्या करेंगे? जो गुडविल ऑलरेडी हमारे पास है वो हम ओल्ड रेशो में पार्टनर्स को डिस्ट्रीब्यूट कर देते हैं. जब भी हम पार्टनर्स को कुछ देते हैं तो उनका कैपिटल अकाउंट क्रेडिट करते हैं. ओके, हमने उनको एक गुडविल का शेयर उनका डिस्ट्रीब्यूट कर दिया ओल्ड रेशो में. बट नाउ देयर इज द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ न्यू रेशो, सो वी हैव टू मेंटेन दिस 18,000 अगेन. हमें 18,000 का गुडविल अकाउंट तो मेंटेन करना होगा जो कि हम ऑलरेडी डिस्ट्रीब्यूट कर चुके थे ओल्ड रेशो में. अब हम वापस क्या करेंगे? न्यू रेशो में उनसे कलेक्ट कर लेंगे. ओके, हमने ए से 6,000 फ्रॉम बी, 6,000 फ्रॉम सी, 6,000. नाउ यू सी ए हैज गिवन 9,000 शेयर बट कलेक्टेड 6,000. इट मीन्स ही हैज गेन्ड 3,000. ओके, नाउ यू सी हेयर. अब यहां पे हमने क्या किया था? ए का कैपिटल अकाउंट क्रेडिट किया था. इट मीन्स इसको जो ये जो सैक्रिफाइस कर रहा था मतलब 1/6 शेयर का, तो उसके बदले में क्या होगा? द पार्टनर हु इज गेनिंग ही प्रोवाइड गुडविल टू द ए, ही गिव्स हिज शेयर टू द ए बिकॉज ही इज गेनिंग इन प्रॉफिट शेयर. ओके, सो इन दिस वे इफ यू हैव टू पास द सिंगल एंट्री एडजस्टमेंट एंट्री यू कैन डू लाइक दिस. बट इफ यू हैव टू रेज एंड रिटर्न ऑफ your goodwill account, first of all you raise the goodwill account, then you write off the goodwill account and you can take the goodwill from the old partners. Thank you, have a nice day.